Hello friends, I welcome you all to Nyandip Academy for UPSC and MPSC. In this session, we are going to study the column analysis of the Hindu dated 14th December 2020. Let's move away to the first column titled Dangerous Impasse. To understand this article, we need to first understand two very important words that are there in this article, and without understanding these words it will be difficult for us to understand the article. The first word is impasse, which means a situation in which no progress is possible because of disagreement, and there is an impasse. If this word is to be used in a sentence, we can say there is an impasse between India and China, because there has been disagreement over the deployment of military forces, of military soldiers, military personnel on the border, to which China disagrees. So it's an impasse. And the next word you need to know is status quo, which means the existing state, which means the state as it was some time back. That is the meaning of the word status quo. Let's move on and let's see the first slide. Let's understand the article. So what is a cause of worry between India and China? What is straining the relationship of India and China? It is the soldiers' deployment in full military preparation by China at the line of actual control. It has been quoted by the Ministry of External Affairs that tens of thousands of soldiers in full military preparation mode are deployed at the line of actual control in Ladakh. This also reminds us of the tragic loss of 20 Indian soldiers in the Galwan Valley in June earlier this year. But China refutes such charges, and instead it blames India for any crisis. This deployment of soldiers by China reminds us of the Sumdurong Chu crisis of 1986. The situation that we are seeing now across the border between India and China reminds us of the Sumdurong crisis. So what is the Sumdurong crisis? Let's see that. Sumdurong is a tributary of the Nyam Yangchu River that flows along the disputed Sino-India border between Tawang of Arunachal Pradesh and Kona County of China. The Sumdurong Valley was site of another standoff between China and India in the year 1986 and 87, and this gave fear of war between the two countries, which eventually, after many years, de-escalated. India-China formulated agreements for managing future border tensions. So this prevailing situation today reminds us of the Sumdurong Chu crisis of 1986. Let's talk of India-China relationships. The Indian-China relationship, owing to this particular military action by China, have strained, and what India wants is normalcy, and there is a reason why India is seeking normalcy of ties between the two countries, because India is well aware that other relationships such as trade, growing links in the field of education and investment are all directly and indirectly related to peace on border, are related to the normalcy relationship between the two countries. What does China have to say about this action? It blames India for the crisis, and it also says that it is abiding by the border agreements that it has, to which it is a partner, and so it refutes all the charges of military deployment. We need to understand that India wishes a peaceful situation. India wishes a normalcy at the border, a situation that was prevalent before May. India wants a status quo in this context. We also need to know that the commander corps, the COP commander talks between the 8th round of COP commander talks between the two countries failed, and there was no positive outcome of these talks. We also need to understand that this time of the year, or this action between the two countries, has dipped the relationship between the two countries and is worst after 30 to 40 years, as is quoted by the Ministry of External Affairs. And to conclude, we can say what is expected of the Indian government and also of the Chinese officials is there should be transparency on the border so that both the countries can maintain a healthy relationship, healthy diplomatic and bilateral relationships. Let's move on to the second article. The second article is titled Breaking Up. So when we say breaking up, what exactly are we talking about? We are talking about Mark Zuckerberg's Facebook and the anti-competitive conduct it is accused of. To understand this article, we need to understand four important terms that are used in the article. First is throttling. Throttling means an attack or to kill somebody by strangulating. So here, throttling means killing somebody. Plaintiff. Who is a plaintiff? A plaintiff is a person who brings a case against another in a court of law. Suit. Suit, it means you take action, lawful action, legal action against another person. And wrath, it means anger. The W is silent, so it is pronounced just as wrath. It means anger. Let's move on to the article. In this case, in the context of Facebook, who are the people who are the plaintiffs? So the people in this, the plaintiff in this context are the Federal Trade Commission, the Attorney Generals of 36 states, United Nations states, I'm sorry, United States of America, District of Columbia, and Territory of Guam. So these are the four plaintiffs who have filed a case in a court against Facebook. What are the charges they are accusing Facebook of? So the first charge they have accused Facebook of is anti-competitive conduct. Second is it harms users, advertisers, competition and innovation. The next is it is apprehensive, it is fearful of competition and therefore it is going towards a monopolistic tendency. It buys competitors or either cuts them off and cuts them off in such a manner that these competitors are not able to access its platform. And this very strategy of Facebook is threatening the world order and therefore it is a cause of concern. And this action of Facebook takes us back to the Cambridge Analytica scandal, that where millions of Facebook users' personal data was acquired without consent, without individual consent, by Cambridge Analytica. This data was to be used for advertising purpose. This scandal is considered to be the biggest knowledge leak in Facebook history. Investigation later on showed that there was actually no misuse, but this misuse of knowledge is considered to be a threat, is considered to be a dent in the image of Facebook and is also a threat for Facebook. Wrath of Mark. So here we're talking about Mark Zuckerberg, and because he realized that Instagram and WhatsApp are gaining popularity and people are flocking to use them, he immediately purchased his rivals, and we all are aware of the deal that took place in 2014, worth $19 billion, where Facebook purchased WhatsApp for that amount. In a similar manner, Instagram was also purchased. So Mark did not want both these to be a competition to him, so instead of that he purchased them. What are the other countries doing in regard to such a scenario? Because this is is limited in a certain way to the United States, but on a global scale, what are other countries doing? Basically, there's a backlash of big tech technology firms, and US and Europe moved against technology companies for violation of privacy and also for antitrust charges. What is required to be done in such a context? What can we conclude with? We can say that the role of regulators and policymakers is very important in this context, because it is these policymakers and regulators who can keep a control on such anti-competitive tendencies and conduct. Second is another way is the breakup of tech firms can be carried out to avoid monopolistic tendencies. And last is competition is necessary. If there is no competition, monopolistic tendencies are going to develop, and it's going to be a one-man say. We're going to be a one-man show. To avoid all this, we need to have competition. If competition is there, the services would reach the consumers at an affordable price also. So thank you. That is all for today's Hindu analysis. See you tomorrow with 15th December's Hindu editorial analysis. Thank you.